kids and JM friends, happy Sunday. There are a lot of competitions that happen all around the world. Have you heard of the Olympics? In the Olympics, people compete to see who is the best or the greatest at a certain sports event. But when it comes to God, there is no competition. There is no one to compete with because God is the only true God. He is greater and better than anything else, and He is also different than anything else. Everything has a beginning, but God has always been. God is all-powerful, all-knowing, and perfect. There's no one like Him. You can trust the one true God. Say it with me. There's only one true God. Now, let's continue the story of Paul, Silas, and Timothy. They were in the town of Thessalonica. Paul preached to the Jews and the Greeks, and some people came to believe in Jesus. God was showing that His plan of salvation is for everyone, whether men and women, adult children, rich or poor. It's for people from all different countries and backgrounds. Yet there were still some powerful men who hated what the missionaries were saying about Jesus. They gathered a huge angry mob and caused an uproar. The mob of the people even attacked the house where Paul had been staying, but it was a good thing that Paul wasn't there. So after being chased out of that town, the missionaries hurried to Berea, where they continued to preach the good news of Jesus. Many men and women believed, but soon some of the men from Thessalonica came to Berea to cause problems there too. The believers in Berea knew that Paul, Silas, and Timothy had to leave. They helped him escape by putting him on a ship to Athens. When Paul got off the ship at the port of Athens, he would have seen buildings that are still there today in 2020. Athens was a beautiful and important city back then and today. What made Athens so special? Well, it was well known for all the philosophers who lived there. Philosophers are people who love to think and talk about what their thoughts are. The philosophers thought they could find the truth by learning a lot and talking about their ideas. They thought they could know the truth without knowing about the one true God. Because they believed in many false gods, there were many idols, statues of these false gods that the people worshipped in Athens. But Paul believed in the one true God, and he worshipped him only. We can worship the one true God too. But how do we worship God? Well, there are different ways. You can think about how awesome God is and remember all the things God has done for you. That's worshiping God through just by thinking. You can say and sing praises to God and just give Him thanks. And you can also tell people about Jesus. That's worshiping God through just by talking or singing. And you can also do something in action to worship God. You can pray, you can volunteer and help, show kindness to others. That's worshiping and honoring God through your actions. And Paul wanted people to know this truth. Paul knew that the many gods of the people in Athens that they worshiped weren't real. As Paul walked through the streets in Athens, he must have seen many statues of like Greek goddesses, and one of them named Athena, like Athens, Athena. There was a huge gold and ivory statue of Athena in the temple high above the city. The people also worshipped many other Greek gods and goddesses whose statues and temples could be seen throughout the city. They thought that these false gods had control over their lives, and many had the power to help them, so they gave honor and respect to these gods. And anything people worship other than the one true God, in the Bible it says they're called an idol. These idols were made from stone, marble, gold, silver, brass, or ivory. And they were beautiful, and you could be seen throughout, even in museums today. And what's interesting is, when I was in college, I took a class called like classical Greek myth. But the word myth right here, it means it's like fake, it's, you know, made up, or it's make-believe. So we know that even non-believers know that these Greek gods and goddesses were a myth, or they're fake. They're not the one true God. And as Paul went through, you know, walking through Athens, he began to get upset because he knew that people were believing in these false gods. And the people of Athens had a statue for almost anything that they could think of. They even had a statue for an unknown god, just in case they missed one. How silly is that? and Paul knew that it was wrong to worship the idols. Now, to hear the rest of this story about Paul and how he continued to preach to the people about Jesus, go ahead and go to the Hope Church website to check out the second part of this week's sermon message. And let's continue to declare that God is the one true God who has the power and who has like sovereignty over all the things that he created on this earth, not the false gods or goddesses that others may believe.